Nearly 300 student and faculty musicians from SUNY Potsdam's Crane School of Music took to the stage this past weekend in celebration of the holiday season to perform the 2022 Crane Candlelight Concerts.
And this year, for the first time, Crane welcomed a special guest conductor, the Reverend Dr. Raymond Wise, an internationally renowned gospel conductor and composer. Dr. Wise led the Crane chorus in gospel renditions of holiday works, including several of his own original compositions.
What are you looking forward to sharing with the audience in this show?
I'm excited about sharing the music, especially those pieces that are from the spiritual and gospel tradition. We're doing a work arranged by Jester Hairston, who's one of the foremost prolific composers or arrangers of concert spirituals. It's called Mary, Mary, Where Is Your Baby? It's the original spiritual that he wrote in the style of a spiritual, but I'm so excited about bringing that piece to life because it's not performed as often, so excited about that. And then of course the other gospel pieces are excited because it's not just for the choir, it's for the audience as well. So our hope is that the joy of the choir will spring into the audience and we give them permission to clap and rock and sing. So to be able to engage the audience and let them join the celebration is so exciting and looking forward to that.
The Crane Jazz Ensemble, directed by Dr. Michael Dudley, joined the performances this year for the first time, taking the stage for several songs, including selections from Duke Ellington's arrangements of the Nutcracker Suite. And the Crane Symphony Orchestra, directed by Dr. Adrian Slywatsky, joined the Crane Chorus for several holiday favorites, including sing-alongs with the audience that made a comeback this year after being put on hold during the pandemic. The Dean of the Crane School of Music, Dr. William Gibbons, told us that the Candlelight Concerts serve as both a North Country holiday tradition, but also as a gift, a way for the school to thank the community.
It is quite a tradition here in the North Country.
It is. I've learned that really quickly. I think I started, as soon as I took the job here, I knew I had to start learning everything I could about everything that was going on. So I went back through old broadcasts year by year by year, and I saw not only how important it was to the students and the faculty here, but also to the community around us.
For the students, for the faculty, what does this concert represent every year?
I think it's a way of bringing together everything that we do here, everything that we do within our closed walls here of music, all the practicing that we do, all the work that we do that maybe is invisible to people who live in Potsdam and people who live in the North Country. And it's our way of taking what we do here and sharing it with everyone around so that we can see how we work together and how important it is for us to be here for our community.
Last year you did have an audience once again, but now with the pandemic another year behind us, it's feeling more back to normal.
Exactly. This is the first fall that's felt normal for us here in a long time. Even last fall, we started masked. It was only towards the end of the semester that we could sort of perform a little bit unmasked. I think many performers were still wearing masks, and that creates a lot of challenges for musical performance. So I think this fall has been fantastic in that everyone feels while we're being safe, there's a lot more opportunity to sort of get back to normal, do what we really take pride in doing, and share that in a sort of unguarded way with our community around us.
One of the nice things about the Candlelight Concert is that you have guest performers and guest conductors, and this year you have a wonderful guest conductor, Dr. Raymond Wise, who is bringing gospel to the Candlelight Concert this year.
Absolutely. So I love that you used the word tradition earlier to describe this. And I love about Candlelight that it is this tradition, but like many traditions, it's always changing a little bit, right? So this is actually the first time we've ever had a guest conductor come in. We have our spring festival every year that usually has some big name celebrated conductor come in. But this is the first time we've brought that also to Candlelight. And we thought we really want our students to have an opportunity to work within the musical traditions that they're familiar with, but also to learn something new. And so it's been a really fantastic opportunity. Everything they've done with Dr. Wise has been wonderful, and I can't wait to share that with the community.
The holiday concert tradition began back in the 1930s and has continued to grow in prominence over the years. Audience members, once again this year, were invited to bring a donation of canned goods to benefit local food pantries. And the Crane Candlelight Concert, Let It Shine, will once again be broadcast here on Mountain Lake PBS this holiday season, premiering on Monday, December 19th at 8 p.m., with several more presentations during the week before Christmas, 9 p.m. on Christmas Eve, and 2:30 in the afternoon on Christmas Day. You can also watch the concert on our YouTube channel.